It is Arizona football today, the Wildcats and Northern Arizona tonight here at the stadium. I'm David Kelly, joined as always by Glenn Howell, U of A football class of 1985. And Glenn, we got Will Plummer starting at quarterback tonight, and that's going to be his first start this season. It's what I said in one breakdown after last weekend's game, that I thought that Will Plummer should have his opportunity, and that's what we're going to see here. And you know, Glenn, I don't begrudge the coaching staff for naming Gunnar Cruz as the first guy that was going to go out there. That was their guy. I mean, that's the guy that they brought in here after they got here in January, and no faults to them. I mean, that's what you want to do. You want to see if your guy can be the one to go out there and get things done. The Will Plummer, though, has been the guy that I thought should be the starter from the get-go. That's where we are right now.
We're going to find out in a few hours, Dave. I'll tell you that right now. I want to see this offense be aggressive. I want them to be able to dominate on the run game, be able to run at will, and then also pass the ball. I want protection for the quarterback. This is a game where we shore up everything before we go up to Oregon, okay? So we have to be able to dominate this game in all facets of the game, special teams, defense, and offense. We have to do it. And up front, I want to see our guys dominate the line of scrimmage. It's got to be a number one priority. And then also, I want to see Jordan McLeod. I want to see McLeod in there and see, let him, what he does. What can he do with this offense against this defense that we're going to face at NAU? And not disrespecting NAU. NAU is a good football team. We always got to respect your opponent, but we should have better players.
So when you look at this offense, and you talked about the protection, and one of the elements that I've noticed, especially in the last ball game, that Glenn, is there's not only been some problems coming off the edge with the offensive linemen, but there's been some problems coming off the edge blocking with the tight ends. They have not blocked well. Alex Lyons, Bryce Woma, in pass protection. If there's one guy I think that's done a decent job in pass protection in terms of the tight ends, it's been Stacy Marshall. And you may, in certain situations, need to go to more max protections where the tight ends and the running backs are involved in the blocking.
Yeah, tight ends, you got to remember, you have to pass block. I remember playing tight end here, we had the pass block. You got to understand, what the guys that you're going to be having on you are either going to be a really fast guy, outside linebacker, and do your steps, do your technique. It's important for them. Then also, we have to be able to clear guys out, we're doing on double teams, and getting up to the next level. That's important for our tight ends to be able to do that. And also, we need to catch the ball. Catch the ball. Make sure you advance the ball when you catch it.
Yeah, there were some drops in that ball game last week. And obviously, when you're dealing with just an offense that's challenged to begin with, the wide receivers have got to go out there and catch the football. You know, establishing that run game is always going to be important. That was something that they were not able to do in the game against San Diego State. So we want to see that as well, being able to operate successfully at all phases of this offense tonight against Northern Arizona. On the defensive side of the ball, Glenn, I want to first focus on the cornerbacks, get your thoughts on how you felt they have played to this point. I think the cornerbacks have played a relatively good through these first two ball games. Christian Roland Wallace had a pass interference, which I can't argue with. I thought that was the right call in the last game, but he's had some pass breakups. Haven't seen a lot of Isaiah Rutherford, which is a good thing because they haven't really been trying to challenge Isaiah Rutherford on that other side. Trayden Stukes has made plays now in both ball games that we've seen. The only maybe guy that's struggled has been Malik Hausman, who's been on the field for two of the biggest offensive plays that have gone against Arizona in these first two games.
Yeah, I think the backhand has done pretty good. We have to be able to lock down this weekend.
Well, I would say the cornerbacks. I wouldn't necessarily say the back end in terms of the safeties because there's some work that needs to be done there.
But they have to be able to lock in this week. This is important for us to do that, to be prepared, because next week against Oregon, boy, we're going to run against you're running against Shetland ponies here. We're going to be running against thoroughbreds next week. Okay, so we have to be able to understand that we have to be able to lock down technique and be able to shut these guys down.
Well, let's talk about then the safeties. Obviously, Gunnar Maldonado got a little bit more run. We can't see the missed tackles we saw from him and a lot of others. He wasn't the only one that missed tackles. Jaden Young missed a key tackle that led to a touchdown. There were 16 in that ball game. You can't continue to play defense like that and be successful against Pac-12.
We got to have zero missed tackles, and stay in the single digits. That's really important for us because we can't afford that. We also have to be able to understand that when we are blitzing, tackle the quarterback. If you have your hands on the quarterback, get on him. And I'm hopefully we're going to get to this quarterback a lot.
Yeah, over-pursuing also, I think, continues to be a little bit of an issue for this defense. Just running themselves, like you always say,
running out.
Assignment and alignment, yep. Running themselves out of that alignment and allowing for a lot of those cutback big runs.
And let's set the edge this weekend. Let's just say you cannot run outside. They got a big back that they have. He's 6'2". They list him on the depth chart as 6'5", but I think he's like 6'2". But 6'2", 225, big back. He's going to try to bruise it. He's going to kind of go inside the tackles and maybe go outside. He shouldn't be getting outside on us.
Yeah, and I think if you set that edge, we'll begin to see these linebackers be able to make a few more plays.
Yeah, I want to hear Pandy's name. I want to hear Hayward's name. I want to hear all these linebackers' names. I want to hear Herbert. I want to hear these guys making tackles 1 to 2 yards behind the line of scrimmage, not 3 to 4, 5, 6 yards behind the line of scrimmage. And even tackle for losses.
Yeah, and you mentioned earlier Northern Arizona. Obviously, this is a game that I love that happens. I love that the Regents make the two big schools play Northern Arizona every other year on their schedules. We get to see Tucson kids come back. Terrell Hayward from Cienega. Jonas Leader is a starter on the offensive line for Northern Arizona. So an opportunity really for those kids to showcase on this stage.
Huge game for those guys. Tucson guys coming home, playing in the stadium that they wish they played in probably. Those guys probably grew up here and saying, I want to be a Wildcat. Now it's their time to shine, and I hope they have a good game for a couple of minutes.
Yeah, Jonas Leader, we mentioned, out of Canyon Del Oro, and Terrell Hayward, who had a touchdown here when the Lumberjacks came down here 2 years ago. All right, it's Northern Arizona and Arizona here at the stadium tonight. Kickoff at 7 o'clock. For Glenn Howell, I'm David Kelly. That's Arizona Today. We'll be back to break it down for you on Sunday night.